Jey Uso and Damian Priest. This, to me, was inevitable, Joe.
No doubt about it. It looked like there was just a moment of hope for Jey, and then all of a sudden, Judgment Day comes right back on top of him as they're taking their turn, and springboard seated and into the cover. The hook of the leg by JD for the win, and a kick out by Jey, who desperately needs to get the tag of Damian Priest.
Let's talk about the history between JD McDonagh and Finn Balor. JD McDonagh was brought into this industry over 10 years ago by Balor, trained in his school in Ireland. So much chemistry, so much cohesion, and that is why they're in complete control now, and things are looking bleak for Priest and especially main event Jey Uso.
You can see JD working that left arm of Jey Uso. That was going on throughout the commercial break when we stepped away for just a moment as well. As Jey back to his feet. Can he find the strength? Can he rally back? Sends a right hand against what the crowd here in Denver was chanting descriptively as bobblehead. Bobblehead. And now a series of yeet-leveling right hands. And one last one for good. Oh, and the bobblehead gets back at him.
So effective, but Jey Uso, with some dying embers in his body, managing to flatten McDonagh and give his team at least a glimmer of a chance, but he needs this tag, Joe.
He's had Enziguri enough to create the opening to let Damian Priest out of the cage. Here he comes. Just smashing his former allies.
As volatile as they come. On the Judgment Day, wanted anything but this.
Oh, big right hand from the big striker and a forearm as well.
There is just a darkness burning inside the massive body of Damian Priest right now. And he's unloading on his former Judgment Day teammates.
How good does this have to feel? And now he's left in there. Oh, he's trying to roll him up. There's Finn. But a kick out.
As good as that fell, things would feel incredibly bad for Priest if he loses this one. Massive limb length coming into play. Cutting off Balor at the pass.
6 foot five plus. And that big leg getting up to take down Finn Balor.
Tapping into that blind rage that cost him at SummerSlam, now using it to his advantage.
He wants south of heaven here in a Rocky Mountain high. Rolled up, countered it. Kick out by Priest.
Now let's not forget, Finn Balor, former world heavyweight champion in his own right. Distraction with the
referee didn't
JD
see it.
JD with the drive by, and there you go.
He didn't see it. Hook of the leg.
Just a late kick out from Damian Priest. Agony on the face of the Punisher. Things might be about to get even worse on the wrong side of the tracks now. Against two men who know his every weakness.
And now a legal man.
Oh. Able to break free in a double clothesline.
There was a tag. I don't think Balor and JD were aware, but the legal man is now Jey Uso.
Double cross body. Super kick. Knocks him out. And another one to JD. Big spear here in the Mile High City.
We are going into meltdown.
He's going to line him up and go up top.
Now to go supersonic on JD McDonagh. Finn Balor.
Oh no! What is Liv Morgan doing? Liv Morgan comes out of nowhere to disrupt Jey Uso's attempt at an Uso splash and crashes him down right on top of the ropes.
Well, if not for that, it was certainly game over for JD McDonagh in the drop zone of Jey Uso, and there's no way back from there without the intervention of Liv Morgan.
Liv Morgan, who started the night brutalizing and injuring Rhea Ripley.
It is going to be a night of glory for Liv Morgan and the Judgment Day.
And now complete control for Finn Balor and JD McDonagh.
This has turned into a walk in the park for the Judgment Day.
Coup de grace! He hits it. Moonsault JD! Hooks the leg! Priest comes in and saves it!
Stirring at just the right moment. That awareness of Damian Priest. That durability.
No! How can it? Her leg is badly damaged! Rhea Ripley! With a crutch to help her left leg as she's being mocked by Liv Morgan. Deriding her, she's the one who did it to her with Dirty Dom.
Rhea Ripley just tough out the most.
On one leg, she's chasing her down.
Rage and fury in her eyes, completely getting rid of the pain in that leg.
What guts and what loyalty by Rhea Ripley.
The Eradicator eradicating the threat of Liv Morgan. And now Priest is about to eradicate the rest of the Judgment Day. Desperately trying to scamper the way out of this, but Priest.
Big spear! JD is going to feel the razor's edge as Rhea looks on.
Loving every second of it.
She is the one who put this team together on short notice. And now Jey Uso, with no Liv Morgan in sight, does land the Uso splash. And the win. How good does that feel, Rhea?
Here are your winners. The team of Damian Priest. A main event, Jey Uso.
Think about the bookend of this night for Rhea Ripley. She was hanging from one leg, caught up in the ropes when the night started, beaten down by Judgment Day. And then she's able to finish off Liv Morgan on one leg and using a crutch as a weapon.
That is called gutting it out. Never, ever write off Rhea Ripley. Although you can write off JD McDonagh after this double whammy razor's edge. Followed by the tag to the Yeet Meister himself and the big top rope splash. We've loved it for years. And Damian